Xenon tetrafluoride. So what's the central atom? Well, if you look at the table of electronegativities, you'll see that, at least the one I give out, xenon's not on there. Well, there are some compounds of xenon and krypton. Is if you have a noble gas compound, make the noble gas the central atom automatically. We put the four fluorines around xenon. We do the valence count. What column is xenon in? It's column 8A. So 8 valence electrons for xenon. Fluorine has 7 valence electrons because it's in 7A. There are 4 of them. 36 total valence electrons divided by 2 is 18. Next rule, bond the surrounding fluorines to xenon. That's 4 pair distributed. The next rule is get the octet rule for the surrounding atoms. So we add 3 more pair to each of the surrounding fluorine atoms. And then you look and go, if the central atom has less than 4, oh wait, I skipped a rule, didn't I? How many pair of electrons have we distributed? 16. How many do we have? 18. So I still have 2 more pair of electrons. The rule says place any remaining electron pair around the central atom. It does not say to do this. You don't make multiple bonds at this point. While it gets your count right, you have 2 problems. First problem, each of those fluorines with a double bond around it, that has 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 electrons, more than 8. Fluorine is in row 2. You can't have more than 8. So that's one problem. But the other problem is one that you don't know yet because we haven't talked about shapes. If this were a good representation of the Lewis structure, this molecule would have a tetrahedral shape. We know that xenon tetrafluoride has a square planar shape. And while we haven't talked about shape yet, I have the Lewis structure wrong. That's going to get me the wrong shape. So let's go back to this. We have 2 more pair. What does the rule say? Place any remaining electron pair around the central atom. It doesn't say to make bonds. Think back when we did ammonia. We had 1 extra pair at the end and we put it on nitrogen. So we do the same thing here. We put the 2 remaining electron pair on xenon. And it just has to be obviously around xenon. And it has to be 2 pair. If you check the formal charges of all the atoms, you'll see that each of the fluorines has a 0 formal charge. And xenon has a 0 formal charge. So this Lewis structure is finished.